Well, hello everyone. I'm Yanni from BeauView Gaming, and today we are back in Bear and Breakfast. And of course, this is still the demo. So let's go over to this crafting table that we just got. So here is our first recipe, bedroom bed one. So we need one plank of the plywood and we need one sheet of cotton. Unfortunately, I have already been hoarding a lot, so we have 70 planks and 22 sheets. That should keep us going for a bit, I think. Okay, let's craft that. Look at that. We have our very first bed. Visit Barbara to turn it in. I noticed a little pop-up down here. That's pretty cool. Okay, so you also get a little reminder about where you need to actually hand it in, but of course that should also show over here, right? You can see who gave you the quest, so that's cool. Mm-hmm. Did you craft a bed yet? Yep, nails and all. Hey, that's not half bad for someone who basically wears oven mitts all the time. Now let's put that to good use. Cool. Okay, so I guess we just have to go and put it in there. Let's see if she has anything new to say. I don't think I've asked what your name is. How very rude of me. Hank. My name's Hank. Bear noises. Yep. Oh, such a beautiful name. I have a hard time remembering these things, of course, so I'll just call you Cubby, if that's all right. What? Wonderful. Well, Cubby, if we want people to come over and stay with us, they're gonna need a place to sleep. Here's a little bit of money, but don't spend it all before we can make some more. We'll need it to build things. Go in that cabin and build me a functional bedroom. You, okay. Yep, so build a bedroom, place a bed inside the bedroom. We already got the bed, but we probably need a little bit more than that, right? So how to build? Press B to enter build mode, a free camera mode that allows you to build things. Nice. Choose whether or not you'd like to build rooms or place objects from your inventory. Ew, okay. Ah, okay, yes, so this is to build or this is to place things, haha, because that's from our inventory, of course. Yep, yep. To build a room, select it from the list, draw the footprint of the room and hit, and then hit next. Make sure you meet the minimum size. Oh, okay, so they have a minimum size too. That's cool. Place a doorway for your room and hit done. Click and place furniture objects from your inventory into the room, only in build mode. Most rooms demand a mandatory object before they can be functional. It makes sense, you need a bed in a bedroom, right? You can place building, you can pause building a room if you don't have the mandatory object, then return to place it. That's always a good thing. Click a room to edit its contents or delete it altogether. Rooms are usually pretty particular about which objects you can place in them. So we can't put a toilet in the bedroom, it looks like. Decoration objects have no restrictions. You can place them wherever. Cool. Okay, let's see if we can figure that out. Nice, so now we're in here. It is kind of a bed and breakfast. I'm kind of thinking the practical place would be to have a bedroom up here, right? But I'm thinking we might want to have a more than one room. But anyway, let's see if we can figure this out. So we press on this and then we have floor, ground floor one or floor two. Oh, okay, maybe we can do something with the room, or maybe some of them has a floor two, right? So let's go back to floor one, which is where we are at. Eastern cabin. And there we go. Then, okay, so rooms, comfort, water, food, utility, and special. There's lots of stuff to choose from. Under comfort, we now have a single bedroom. Let's see what we have with the other ones, because I'm curious. Small public bathroom. We have a kitchen and a dining room. Oh, come on. We have a utility room and we have the lounge. Oh, so that's lots of stuff. Okay, a single bedroom. Yes. Okay, so I'm kind of thinking, I think that would start all the way over here. I haven't really lowered the walls, I guess. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Minimum size is 2 by 3. I'm thinking a 2 bedrooms could be handy here, right? I don't know how many we would want, but or maybe even fewer than that. I think I like having a little smoothed back. Oh, but 2x3 minimum size. That's kind of a tiny bedroom. Look at that. 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3 or 1, 2, 3. That's just this. That looks like a very tiny bedroom. But maybe we don't want them to be too big. I don't know. That's something to figure out, right? So let's see if we go with something like this. For starters, selection outside buildings blueprint. Oh, okay. So I guess this is outside. If I go here and do this. Aha. Oh, oops. Somehow I ended up with a double one, I think. A blueprint. Okay, so you can press. What does minus and plus do? Doesn't do anything. Minimum size 2.3. Draw blueprint. Oh, okay. So then you can just go back. Let's try that again. So if you do something like this. Oh, it's like a column. Right. So that's the walls, I guess, that goes up to here. Okay, now we're that far, then I guess we just press this. Uh-huh. Then we need to place a door, so we can put a door over here, or we can have a door over here, I guess. Maybe. Can we not do it? Oh, okay, rotates, that's good. Anyway, I can rotate the screen, because that's actually kind of tricky to see where you place things. This way, I would have liked to be able to rotate. Q and E doesn't do anything. Middle mouse button, no. Okay, we can zoom in and out, but I don't think we can actually kind of rotate. Oh, where did my door go? Place door. Okay, we're gonna go back one. Say okay, and now we have the door. Because I'm not sure. Well, on the other hand, we could have the door here, and then we could have another room over here facing this way, right? Let's try that. Because it's really hard to center it here and or see where you have put it, right? There we go. So now we have a door. Ooh, there we go. Build a bedroom ready. Visit Barbara to turn it in. And then I set something underneath. They do disappear a little bit fast, these things. Okay, so that's our bedroom. Cool. Let's see, I would like to, because we do have a bed, right? So, how do I... Oh, there we go, okay. Yep, so now we can place this here. How far back down can we go? We can go like this. We can press R to rotate it. No, I don't think I want it there. Okay, or we can put it right in the middle. That could be an option too, right? So we put it right here. Okay, so far so good. Oh, okay, and then when you mouse over it, you can see plus 5 because there's a bedroom and plus 1. I guess that's just for it being a room or something. I don't know what the difference is between those two. That one of them is comfort. I don't know. I think, oh, I guess the bed is a decoration, right? It looks like a flower icon plus 1. That's probably because it's decoration or something, or counts as decoration. Cool. Let's just do this. And then let's try to, well, they are actually lowered. Right, so yeah, see, that's because the wall has this height here. And then we have this, and then we can go all the way down. There we go. Okay, well, we have a beginning to our bedroom there. That was a little bit confusing. I do still kind of wish you could rotate it so that you can see from the sides, but maybe you can. I just haven't figured out how to do it. Move, zoom, use, interact, character, inventory, quest log, build mode. Buy items, let's stack, rotate object or door. I figured that out. Because I is very often used, right? G, my cabin, quick save, quick load. Okay. Well, let's just save again, because now we have our bed place. So that's nice. Did you build a nice bedroom? Yep, all done. Excited bear noises. Brilliant. It's not the skyline heights, but it'll do. Now let's see about getting this place up and running again. Ooh, bedrooms. Go in build mode and build a bedroom. That's what we did. Craft and place any one bed, which is a main comfort object. Uh-huh. You can place additional comfort objects in a bedroom, but lower level beds can only sustain one. Can only sustain one. So does that mean if I have a lower level bed, then I can only have... Ah, yeah, you can see this is a level one bed, so I have to have a better bed before I can place more objects, I guess. Interesting. Craft and place a high level bed for the ability to place multiple additional comfort objects. Oh, okay. That's something to figure out. That looks spectacular. I can barely believe it. I think the resort is just about ready for its grand reopening. Oh, wow. She's optimistic. There's just one last thing we need. Be a dear and go fetch me a couple of things so I can fix up the sign up front, will you? You should have most of it from the rubble, but if you don't, just check the buildings. Oh, and about that bucket of paint. I'm pretty sure I saw that damned raccoon with it. Oh, bucket of paint. Okay, that's because you need it for the entryway sign. So we need 4 plywood planks, 2 iron nails, which we have, and then the bucket of red paint. I did see that when we were down at the shop. Chuck's garbage shop. There's garbage everywhere, and in Pinefall, that's money, baby. Press E to loot it. Mm-hmm. So Chuck's garbage shop. Visit Chuck's dumpster diving display to buy decorative objects for your cabin, including lights. Keep an eye out for guests who occasionally drop garbage, which affect your deco score. But of course, this is what I was mentioned last time, that that's probably how you keep getting more garbage, because eventually you'll have picked up everything around here, right? Even though there's lots to, you can even easily overlook some of it. There we go. I just simply have to hoard a little bit because I haven't done any yet. Okay, we can't fix the fences yet. Of course, there's the other rooms, but we couldn't really decorate them in the demo, so I don't know if I'm going to spend any time on those at all. We can probably still go inside and loot, right? See? So we can still do this if you want all the goodies from here. But let's try and go down here. I think it was down here somewhere that we met Chuck. So maybe you were a little bit further over. It was kind of when we were... Yeah, it was almost over by the river, wasn't it? It's close to, anyway. So, let's just try and wander this way. Okay, now we're kind of at the... Or where the river has turned, it looks like. So at some point it should start going up again. Okay, well, let's just grab a few more things while we're here. Thank you. Oh, marble. Nice. Okay. Look at that, we are getting porcelain. Cool. Uh-huh. Okay, well, let's grab this as well. So it's not just bricks you can find down here, though we still do find some of those. Okay, so this is kind of where we were. See, this is where the chamomile was, right? So it does seem like it respawns. It's a new day. Well, it's day 4 now, so it does seem like it respawns over time, and then you can come back and get more of it. That's always nice, right? I do like that it's, there seems to be some things that you can only get in specific places. I don't know about you guys, but I kind of like that it's something you have to learn over time and then remember it for later if you need more of that item, right? Okay, I can't seem to pick this up. Okay, but over here is where Tuk should be, right? So let's have a little look here. There was the paint that is right here. Okay, so I have 278. Okay, that didn't cost me anything. So we're just gonna kind of take it back from Chuck. Then we have a wall tapestry. We have a toolbox. We have terrarium. That's kind of cool. We have some some potted plants and stuff. I'm just thinking if there's something I want to put in the bedroom. There's a rustic end table. That's pretty cool. There's a mouse lamp. We have a large table lamp. Large leafy lamp. Very nice. What else do we have in here? Ooh, a large rock. It might be nice with a rock on. Ooh, a medium rock. The only thing is, I don't know what size it would have to be to fit under the bed. I was kind of thinking about something and I would like it to be a little bit bigger. Oh, there's a cuckoo clock. Oh, that's cool. Let's get that. So, it is actually gives 2 decor. Does that mean it's a level 2 decor item? Or is it just because it adds 2 decor? Because it does have 2 like flower things. Does everything have 2 flower things? Maybe they do. Most of it does. Okay, so we're gonna buy this. Oh, here we go. Click. We have 278. That only went down by 2. I'm pretty sure the pants were like 100. They still say 100. So yeah, we didn't have any other clothing in here, right? We have a plaque. No, not really that I can see. Okay, but it's not that far. Quickly you'll figure out the shortest way to get here, right? When you play the game, and then it shouldn't be take that long to run back if we need it, because here's the other building over here, right? So we just have to go up here. Pretty much just go through here and then you almost end up down there, right? This is almost like it's pointing right down there. Very handy. Until this maybe gets removed or updated or something. Maybe we can remove it and build a better one. Did you get the materials I asked for? Yep, every last bit. Oh. Let's see. Repair the entryway sign completed in Pinefall Resort. Cool. I'm so happy. Thanks to you, we can finally start rebuilding this magical place. Pinefall Resort is now officially open for business. Mm-hmm. Cool. The tourists are just pouring in. Okay. Like I said, she's very optimistic. Stupendous. Thank you. That is such a relief. I don't think I've told you a lot about this place, have I? Well, I don't think it would do much harm.
Pineball Resort used to be a magical place. The jewel of the valley. Charming and beautiful. If you didn't mind the dictatorship. Well, we tried to keep it that way at least. You see, it had a common and unfortunate affliction. Other people. But as bad as this contamination was, it was also necessary. The little dung these pests left behind was of great value, and it made for fertile soil to grow and grow. But even so, the resort was beholden to its cruel owners. So we had to give up part of the treasure. For the greater good, I suppose. When the regime fell 15 years ago, everything came crashing down after it. And so did we. The visitors stopped coming. The wealth ran out. The world collapsed. Our world collapsed. And now all that's left are run-down buildings and piles of garbage. And me, alone, ever since.
Aww. Well, that's the gist of it anyway. Anyway, no matter. We have more work to do. Grand reopening. Pinefall Resort is officially reopened for business. Guests will now request to stay at your bed and breakfast. Oh, cool. Aha. Well, I like that. I like the story, that there's a story part like that too. That is so cool. Oh, yes. I hope there'll be a bunch more of that along the way. Okay, but let's go and check out. It's kind of getting a little bit dark. Late in the day. Oh, man, that's not really a good first impression, is it? Right here. Open, and then we have all this trash lying around. Can't have that. No. Here we go. Let's do this. And look at that. We have our brand new sign. Very cool. Yep. And let's have a little look up here where it looks like we have a little bus stop. Nice. Yep. Cool. Ooh, and more goodies. That's not good. It's not good. Well, I call them goodies, but I don't think the guests would look at it like that. No. Where did we actually leave our friends? It was somewhere over here to the right, I think. So we have another strawberry bush. Yeah, we could see her cabin from where we came with them, so it must kind of be up here somewhere. I wanted to try and see if we could actually do anything to bring them in here as well, or maybe that's not part of the demo, right? Probably can in the full game, otherwise there's not much point in bringing them along, right? So I'm pretty sure we can do something with them, but maybe not here. Let's see. Okay, we have our path here. Yes. Look at this. I've got a bad feeling about this. Okay, it looks like that is not... There's nothing here. Yeah, I'm sure that is around here somewhere. Yep. Okay. So that would be something for the full game. Mm-hmm. Ooh, can we actually access the rest of the cabin now? Oh, we can. Just because I'm curious. Oh, it's not so polite, I guess. Oh, look at that, we can turn the light. Oh, look at that. I like that. It's just a tiny detail, but really, really cool. It is a little funny, though, that we can walk. I don't think that's intended. We can walk behind this shelf here. Because it looks like it's supposed to hang on the back wall and not over the bed, right? So, it was just a tiny detail. There we go. Okay, let's go back and see, because Barbara might have something new for us to do. So, we're going to head back down. But we're kind of getting the idea now of how this is all gonna work. We're gonna see if there's gonna be any guests coming in the morning, potentially. Right now it is a 2 a.m. Aha, ooh, look at that. What is this? Tomatoes. Oh. Yeah, we have like 15 of those. And of course we can go here and look into making more rooms. That's probably a good idea. Now we're ready to get our first guest. I'm sure there's someone requesting a stay by now. Come back to me once you've booked someone. Ooh, okay, your cabin. Oh, booking guests, press G to open your cabin menu. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at that. Now we actually have a room, right? We have a single bedroom with 5 comfort and 1 decoration. We do have something we can add in here to increase the decoration. And apparently there's other stats here, it looks like, that you can increase over time, right? We do have a stay request. Olaf Murrow came from far away to see the beautiful landscapes, likes taking pictures. Oh, so this is his requirement, right? So each guest will have certain requirements that we have to have 5 comfort, in this case 0 hygiene, 0 decoration, and 0 food is needed. But of course, as you progress, they will be more and more demanding, and then you have to make sure to have rooms that meet this. And then we have reviews. Let's go and place the cuckoo clock before we accept our new guest, right? I think that's what we're gonna do. We're going to go up here and then we are going to press this one. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to go in here and then we're going to take this. Here we go. I have to left click on it. And okay, so, yes, because it has to hang on the wall. I was like, why is it red? But that's because it has to hang on the wall. So there we go. Now we're going to hang it right over here. Cool. Now we can close this, and that means when we look at this, now we have 3, and we can of course see where we get it from. So we get +1 from the bed and 2, so +2 is exactly what we get, right, from the cuckoo clock. Cool. So we have +3. That is more than he actually wants, but that's okay. Now that we bought it, I kind of feel like this is a very small room. It's not really that fancy, but there we go. He looks like someone who's probably going to be spending most of his time maybe fishing down by the river or something. So I don't think he has the big or that many requirements. He just needs a bed to sleep in, right? There we go. Cool. And then we can press select again and then we can actually see it here. Okay, so your cabin. Now we should have accepted. The room list will show all functional bedrooms you have built. Stay requests will show all the guests that are currently looking for a room to stay. Cabin reputation will show you all the ratings guests leave at the end of their stay. To assign a guest to a room, check out his score requirements. Indeed, that's what we did, and hit accept. Select a bedroom that meets all the guests' requirements or don't. I won't judge. But you might not get the best reviews, right? Okay, there we go. So now we have this. Cool. So if we press G again. Why does it say empty now? No guests' requests yet. Did he already leave again? Current guests 1. No, we still have 1 guest. Okay. It would be strange if he already left. Okay, so now let's go down here. Assign a guest to a bedroom. But I already did that. Accept a guest. Assign a guest to a bedroom. Single bedroom. 1 day is remaining. It already did that. Okay, maybe he has to actually arrive to his bedroom before this gets updated. Let's see, because he is going upstairs now, so... Looking good! Nice! Okay, can I talk to him? No. Okay. Okay, I think I kind of messed it up somehow, maybe because I messed around with the designing the room in between or something, because somehow it didn't get updated. So, did you find the first sucker? I mean, guest. Yeah, I got someone coming. Approving bear noises. Brilliant. Let's wait for them to show up and then see if we can't make their stay a little more bearable. Okay, so okay, so that got updated. We just needed to talk to Barbara. Bedrooms, comfort, guest scores. Comfort, bedrooms, and their objects will determine a guest's comfort score. Come on, stop that. Hygiene, bathrooms, and their objects will determine a guest's hygiene score. Food, meals, placed in serving tables, found... Oh, you've got a new stay request. Okay, but this down here, I wish that wouldn't disappear so fast, because I only managed to read the first one, and the second said something about that he checked out, and then I didn't see what the last one was. So it would be nice if that stayed a little bit longer. Placed in serving tables, found in dining rooms, will determine that score for guests. Cool. Heat, an active heater in a utility room will maintain a guest's heat score. Decoration objects will determine how happy a guest is with their deco score. Click a guest's review after their stay to check out a deep dive of their experience. In build mode, hover any placed object to see the stats it gives. Guest scores. Also in build mode, hover any build room to see all the stats it receives. Gives. That's what I noticed that we could do. Cool. Okay. Well, if we press G now, and then we are going to go to reviews. Olaf Murrow. Great. Best day ever. I already booked another stay in advance for the next year's vacation. That's cool. So, it's a 6 stars. Rating 6, but it only shows 4 here and then not this one. Not sure how that actually works. I would have thought maybe this counted as 10 stars, but then it should only have been 3 of them. But anyway, we got 6 stars. That's not bad. Total score 200. Trip quality incredible. Great. Best day ever. Yes, that's what I read. Comfort, comfortable. And of course, we didn't really have much of this. He didn't really care much about decoration. Base pay, 225, so we made a little bit of money. Cool. Okay, so let's check out. Oh, wow. Oh, okay, they have all kinds of demands here. Look at that. Definitely gonna have to update some things before we accept any more, right? I think for the fun of it, we're gonna accept someone. Who has the lowest? Henrik has the lowest, right? 9, 10, but then you have 4 here. Just for the fun, you do want to stay for 2 days, but let's try. Accept and then select. He's not going to be happy, but just for the fun of it, let's try that. And now that the bedroom is sorted, you'll need to start taking care of other needs your guests might have. Tell me, have you ever heard of soap? We are not animals. Annoyed bear noises. Of course not. That's all right. Well, some people haven't heard of it either, so we should make sure we spread the word loud and clear. There's nothing funny about personal hygiene. Go ahead and craft these lovely pieces of furniture and build a pretty little bathroom. Ooh, so we got a bathroom washer. We got a bathroom toilet and a sink. Nice. Ooh, okay, so now we have a tutorial about that. Go in build mode and build a bathroom. Craft and place a sink, washer and toilet to make it functional and give hygiene score. Cool. Bathrooms only grant a score to the bedrooms in an area around them. Oh, so it has an area of effect. Oh, so it's a good idea to actually have that centered. Well, I was thinking that I wanted to have it up here, near here, but we might need a little bit more room, room for it. To put it, I was thinking about putting a bedroom here, but I'm kind of thinking maybe we want a bathroom here, and then we could have a bedroom, and they would all work there. But maybe we want something else up here aside from that, or we want the bathroom in the middle, and then we can have a bedroom here, we can have another bedroom down here, right? But I'm kind of thinking we might want to have something else up here. That's the thing, I don't know, because there were some other rooms, right? There's like the lounge, but maybe that's what we would want downstairs, right? But very often they have, there's like a little place upstairs. Kitchen and dining room. Yeah, dining room we would definitely have down. I'm kind of thinking the lounge is something I would have put up here. Okay, but we are completely out of time for this. We'll see, maybe I'll do one more video of this little demo here where we build the bathroom and see what the next room is gonna be. We'll see, but so far I'm really liking it. It's really casual and I like the fact that there is this story side of it, and I'm quite excited to see how it's gonna work when we get more people that we can actually meet and bring in our friends, and there's probably gonna be quests and stuff with them as well, right? Because according to the description on the Steam store page, there are gonna be, you know, people that you go out and explore and meet, and then maybe you can do quests with them and things like that, aside from just running your bed and breakfast. But yeah, that was it for this video, so thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.